Good morning, everyone. We're still talking about the promises of God. God promises us a lot of things. God's promises are sure. They're faithful. They're anchors for our souls. God's promises speak joy to us. They speak hope to us. They speak peace to us. They're promises of deliverance, and we've been through several of these. But today I want to talk to you about a promise many of us don't want to think about. We know it's there, yet we typically kind of leave it alone. What am I talking about? I'm talking about a promise of home. Home represents a lot of things to us. At the end of a long journey, it means rest. To several young people, it means security. Peace, wholeness, rest, home. Many times I've come back from a long trip or something, and I just want to get home. I don't need to go to a restaurant. I don't need to do all this. I just want to get home for the peace and the rest and the security that is there. Because I know there I can shut the door and just go, this is good. Jesus has promised each one of us who believe in him a home. He's promised us a home. Here's what he says in John 14, chapter 2 and 3. That's why we kind of, we know it's there, and it's the assurance of our souls, it's the promise of God, but you know, we just kind of don't talk about it unless we're talking about what heaven is going to look like. But here's what Jesus says. In my Father's house are many dwelling places, many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I'm going to prepare a place for you. If I go to prepare a place for you, I am coming again and will receive you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. There's a lot packed into that. But the basic promise is, Jesus says, I have a home for you. Now, there are folks who are homeless, and they read this verse, and they go, God, when? Yes, I understand that. In my own tradition, spirituals talk about heaven. You know, there's a welcome table. There's a home waiting for me on the other side. Yes, because Jesus has promised that, promised each one of us a home, a place of rest, a place of security, a place of joy, a place where we can be with the Father. Sit at the banquet table. Be with him. Jesus has gone to prepare that place for us. Then he says this. I prepared it, and I will meet you and call you unto myself. I'm coming again and will receive you. Think host at the door. Someone who welcomes you in. When my daughter and I bought our home, you know, our realtor was so excited to give us the keys. He ran up to the door, opened the door. This is yours. That's what Jesus is saying. Why? Because he gives us a home. It is our home forever. In preparing for this, I was looking for some hymns on heaven and home. I ran across this one. I like this because of the refrain that it says. It says, here's the verse. Over yonder stands the mansion Christ prepared for me. God ordained that I should have it for eternity. Amen? And now stand, send a prayer before me before I cross the foam. And here's the line. Angels, get my mansion ready. I'm coming home. I'm coming home to heaven where the angels there to dwell. I'm coming home to glory, and I'll never say farewell. I'm coming to that city, never more to roam. Angels, get my mansion ready. I'm coming home. Why? Because that is a reality for us. Jesus has promised us a home, a place of dwelling, a place of security, a place where we will be made whole, rest, encouragement, peace. Woody Guthrie has an old song. I know I'm old. Woody Guthrie was a folk singer way back in the 20s and 30s and 40s. He wrote this, "Heaven my home. This old world just ain't my home. Trying to make heaven my home. I lift and I bend, I sweat and I strain. This old world ain't my home. Every job I touch is aches and pains. I gotta make heaven my home. Trying to make heaven my home. Trying to make heaven my sweet home. This old world, Jason, ain't my home. Trying to make heaven my home." Why? Because that is Jesus' promise to us. This is just basic instructions before leaving earth. Bible, basic instructions before leaving earth. We get to enjoy this, which is a dim reflection of what our home looks like, what God has created for each and every one of us. And Jesus says, "I go to prepare your house. Angels, get my mansion ready. I go to prepare this for you." It's Jesus' promise. And I know when we get called home, because that's what it is, when we lay down this mortal flesh, we're just getting called home. And when we get called home, we see our loved ones, we see Jesus. We're just getting called home. Jesus says, "I've gone to prepare a place for you. I want it to be ready when I call you home." Because that is how much the Father loves us. He gives us this promise. He doesn't leave us out here. What's going to happen next? In our modern world, our modern culture today, people go, "Well, you just lay there." No. Jesus has promised us a home. He has promised us that when we get called home, we are in His presence. That's the joy of understanding and knowing Him, that He has a home for us. I'm going to close this with a letter. This is a letter that someone wrote. Actually, the person's name is Harry Reamer. And so he is writing this to the Old Fashioned Revival Hour, which is a Fuller Seminary program started by Charles Fuller. But here it is, because it's about heaven, about our home. He says, "How can I speak this way? Several years ago, Dr. Harry Reamer, noted author of good books, which wrote the following letter to Dr. Charles E. Fuller of the Old Fashioned Revival Hour. Next Sunday, you're going to talk about heaven. I'm interested in that land because I have clear title to a bit of property there for over the last 50 years. I didn't buy it. It was given to me without money, without price. But the donor paid a tremendous price of sacrifice for my home. I'm not holding it for speculation since the title is not transferable. It's not on a vacant lot. For more than a half a century, I have been sending materials out of which the greatest architect and builder of the universe has been building a home for me. That home will never need remodeling or repairs because it suits me perfectly, individually, and it will never grow old because I won't grow old anymore. Termites cannot undermine its foundations, for they rest upon the rock of ages. Fire cannot destroy it. Floods cannot wash it away. No locks or bolts will ever be placed on the doors, for no vicious person can ever enter that land where my dwelling stands. Now, almost completed and almost ready for me to enter in and abide in peace eternally without fear of being ejected. There's a valley of a deep shadow between this place where I live and that to which I shall journey in a very short time. I cannot reach my home in that city without passing through this valley, but I am not afraid, because the best friend I ever had, went through the same valley long ago and drove away its gloom. He has stuck with me through thick and thin since we first became acquainted 55 years ago. And I hold his promise in printed form, never to forsake me or leave me. He will be with me as I walk through the valley of the shadow, and I shall not lose my way, because he is with me. Dr. Fuller, I hope to hear your sermon on heaven next Sunday, but I have no assurance that I shall be able to do so. My ticket to heaven and home has no date marked for the journey, no return coupon, and no permit for baggage. Yes, I'm ready to go. I may not be there while you're talking about heaven next Sunday, but I'll meet you there someday. Dr. Reamer, didn't get to hear Dr. Fuller's sermon the following Sunday, because before Sunday arrived, he said good night here and woke up in his new home. My friends, in order to be heaven bound like this, know Jesus. Be blessed today, my dear friends, because Jesus has promised you and me a home. Amen.